Hi, welcome to the Reclaim Me channel, and today we talk about file storage basics. A file system is designed to store files in some structured way. A file is required to have content and size. All other properties, by and large, are optional. At the physical level, a file is stored on a device, which is usually cut into sectors or some other blocks. Thus, a physical disk cannot write or read data from the arbitrary location, for example, from the middle of the sector, or in a chunk of arbitrary length, for example, you can't read half of a sector. Thus, a sector is a minimum quantum of disk space. A physical device operates with. A file system, in turn, does not allocate disk space up to the byte and operates with sectors too. More than that, when it comes to large files, it does not make sense to maintain accuracy even to sectors. And the file system uses blocks of several sectors, which are called clusters. Thus, a cluster is the minimum quantum of disk space a file system operates with. Clusters are sometimes called blocks, for example, in Unix file systems, but actually it is the same thing. Often a file system needs to append data to the file. If there is a free space in the last cluster, the data is written to the end of the cluster. Otherwise, another free cluster is allocated. A file system, if possible, tries to allocate clusters sequentially, but if this is impossible, because the next cluster has already been used by another file, a non-contiguous cluster is allocated. Let's imagine that we have three files stored on a disk. File 1. File 2 and file 3. If we need to append the data to file 1, a file system allocates this cluster. But if we need to append the data to file 2, a file system cannot allocate the next cluster because it has already been used by the file 3. And a file system allocates another non-contiguous cluster, for example, this one. Thus, file 2 is stored in two non-contiguous fragments. This is called fragmentation. Along with file content, modern file systems store other file characteristics like file names, the date and time of file creation, the access rights, and so on. Typically, the set of these characteristics is called metadata. Metadata is usually stored along with the data about the location of data blocks on a disk. In Linux, the record storing metadata along with pointers to file content is called an inode. So we have a physical disk which is cut into clusters. Typically in the beginning there is file metadata. File names are usually stored in some other place which is called directory. Additionally, there are file systems in which file names are stored inside corresponding inodes, for example in TFS, and file systems in which file names are evenly distributed across file system metadata, for example Apple file systems. Along with features discussed, there is a bunch of others which a particular file system can support or not, depending on what the file system is designed for. The list of features includes sparse files. There is no sense to store zeros on a disk, and if there is a large block of zeros, larger than a cluster, a file system can create a record that zeros should go there rather than actually storing zeros. For example, we have a file with non-zero data in the beginning and in the end, and with zeros in the middle. In this case, only non-zero data will be actually stored. And the file will occupy the same space no matter how many zeros are in the middle of the file. The next feature is built-in compression. A file system compresses data before writing it to a disk. As a result, files occupy less disk space. One more feature is built-in deduplication. A file system monitors that exactly one copy of each data block is stored on a disk. So if we need to store two identical files, only one physical copy will be actually stored, thus saving half of disk space. The same approach can be applied to parts of the files. For example, we have a file storing a block identical to a block already stored on a disk. In this case, only block with different data will be actually stored, while the block with identical data will be stored in one copy. When files are fragmented or stored in some modified form, when sparse storage, compression or deduplication are used, carving for files by looking for their header signatures becomes impossible. The next feature is journaling. Before writing metadata, a file system writes a new version of metadata to some place which is called an intent log. This allows to avoid a situation when a failure happens in the middle of the write. No matter when a failure happens, at least one copy of correct metadata exists. One more feature is copy on write. While journaling uses shortened entries to describe changes in metadata, copy on write creates the exact copy of metadata. Both journaling and copy on write produce additional copies of metadata, which facilitate data recovery. The lifetime of copies stored in a journal is shorter than those produced by copy on write. This is because the journal is limited in size. And the last feature is checksums. A file system can use checksums for metadata and for files. Checksums allow to detect inconsistencies in data written and read. When a disk failure does not lead to a bad block, but instead results in, say, misdirected read. When instead of the requested sector, some other sector is read. There are a few other tricks used to store files in less disk space and more efficiently, but I will expand on these along with their respective file systems. In the next video, I will discuss metadata, what kinds of metadata exist, and how it is arranged. Reclaim team was with you. See you soon!